Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take on its reaction to two songs in this one video. These are requested by our patron Samuel. And the first song that we will be reacting to is Here Comes the Hotstepper. It's a song by INI KAMOZE. And this is the first time that we are going to listen to INI KAMOZE. The second one would be interesting. It's a song by the Kinks. We have reacted to Kinks three times so far. And this time it's going to be for the song Victoria.
This song Here Comes the Hotstepper was very popular. So I have heard it in my college days.
It is that old?
Yeah, it's 90s. Two decades. Yeah. So I think it's the same song. I remember this INI KAMOZE.
KAMOZE, okay.
Name is right. Here Comes the Hotstepper. The King song I've not heard. Let's get started with INI KAMOZE. Here Comes the Hotstepper.
I have heard this part.
Here come the hot snapper. I'm the lyrical gangster. Big up the crew in the area.
Thank you.
so enjoyable to listen
it
to.
It was fun.
It after years. What about you? You say you heard the tunes.
Yes, I didn't realize it was like the whole song this long and this much of lyrics and singing. But na 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 na. It used to be very common and very popular. And this song, I think probably may have played almost at any party. At least, you know, at the end of the last century and beginning of this century. Mm. That time it used to be very common. For most parties, people would have it in their collection. And this would be like one of those songs which would play almost every time with the dance songs that we reacted to some of them in the beginning of October. Scatman and what was that? The another dance song that we have. No.
Blue?
No, the Wayne song. Mr. Wayne.
Mr. Wayne.
Yeah.
Beat,
yeah. So these songs used to be, I think, on everybody's playlist, or once people heard it at somebody's party, they would take the reference and they would keep, you know, playing at their parties. So these would keep on rolling. Music at that time used to keep on rolling from one cassette to the other to the other. People would hear something nice and they would make sure that they were going to take it and go along. Those days there was no internet, there was no YouTube to instantly, you know, type and check whose song it is, and people nowadays just listen to it on their smartphones. But those days it used to be the cassette that used to be very common. Then later on came the CDs and everything. So people would take somebody's cassette, try and record it on their own, and then keep passing it on to other people. Mm-hmm. So this song was one of the popular songs those days. I didn't remember, you know, listening to it the entire song sitting in one go, but that na 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 na. I think it is used in many things as well. Maybe serials here and there, just for that bit. It's a common bit.
Yeah, it's got a very catchy hook.
Yeah, it's simple, easy for people to remember and say.
Beautiful song to talking mainly about himself and his crew. I think that's what I gathered from
it. It was just words put together, I felt.
No, mainly about him. Mainly about the group or the troop of this. You know, what
the
all
group.
They stand for, what all they do, how they are, you know. I like the scratching. The scratching
is
insane.
Yes, that is a lot.
Lot of scratching, lot of good music, good beat, very well sung. Yeah, so definitely a fun song to listen to. Yeah, I mean, here comes the Hotstepper. I'm assuming Hotstepper is a term for probably a good dancer or something like that. Hotstepper.
Someone who's very important at parties or something like that.
Someone like that.
VIP. Someone enters and, you know, everyone is bowled over. I mean, these days big songs come and they do become big, but they don't have that kind of a charm that earlier songs used to have. Songs like this, the last song that I remember when I was in my college and it came out was Temperature. What's his full name? Sean Paul. He is Indian descent as well, part of Indian and West Indies. Sean Paul, right?
Not sure.
Yeah,
not
I sure. Think he's got Indian roots as well as from West Indies. That's what I know about him. And that was huge again. Temperature. That was the last song I remember being that big among young people and
that
making a
did something like that.
Yeah, it had a very catchy, very, you know, addicting tune to it. Temperature. It would end with temperature. And here in India, a lot of people would call him Scene. They didn't know how to pronounce, because all of them, all the young people had got the music and the beat and they would listen to it. But people don't know the names from the West that commonly here. So there would be fights or arguments over how to pronounce his name correctly. He suddenly shot to popularity with that number. And so may have been INI KAMOZE.
Yeah, the lyrics, just to go through it, because I'm the lyrical gangster, murderer. Big up all crew, bow ya, murderer. Still love you like that, murderer. Here comes the Hotstepper, murderer. I'm the lyrical danger, murderer. Pick up the crew in the area, murderer. Still love you like that, murderer. Why is it murderer added after every line?
I don't know.
Line,
the it's comma danger, gangster, stepper and murderer.
Is it like the guy who is so big and so scary like a gangster or something, gang lord, godfather maybe, that just get away, get out of the way or you are in trouble.
Whatever may be the reason to add so many murders, I think it's just way of rhyming things with one word. I felt the lyrics were all about throwing some words, saying certain words or certain set of words very nicely, like oh Mr. Officer and all those things. People remember that and people only repeat when those lines come or those specific words come in a song. There was another song that became very, very, very big when I was young. If you may also remember, but you may have been little older than me at that time. Who let the dogs out?
Yeah.
That was insane. That was crazy. I don't know how many versions people made over here of that song.
And it comes in a movie also, I think.
I don't know if it comes. Yeah, it does. Maybe actually, it comes. Movies. It comes. It has come.
Must be probably in a dog movie. Movie.
Yeah.
And probably in
it some became movie. Like dog's anthem as well.
Yeah.
We could get the video of it. It used to be crazy and party like something. A home and outside the parties going on. And that song would come. That was crazy in India. Or maybe only in Mumbai. But this, every youngster knew it.
This is also a good song for a car.
Yeah.
You're riding in a car, driving. It's a good song to just chill out, listen to while you're driving, enjoying the scenery, looking both sides of the road. Unless you're the driver, but if you're in the back seat,
people like
look at both sides and enjoy. It's good for those cars which bounce up and down.
Yeah,
what are those bouncing cars called?
I don't know.
They were
but
popular in the early 90s.
I don't know if it here, no, but it was them. in America. It was.
Yeah, and even in certain other countries, Middle East and all that, they had become popular at one point in time, those cars. I don't know how it was done. I think something to do with the shock absorbers.
Those are called those things. What are they? Suspenser or something, they call it.
Shock absorbers.
Ah, you're right, yeah. In motorcycles, it is called.
Let's move to the next song, The Kinks.
Kinks, Victoria.
Victoria, okay.
It's a weird combination though. These two songs. Yeah. I don't know how King's Victoria is going to be like. But this was completely different.
Who knows, maybe it's similar. That would be a pleasant surprise.
That would be, yeah. Namaste and welcome back to our reaction. We are going to react to The Kinks. The song is Victoria. We have reacted to The Kinks in the past as well. I like their music. The most favorite of mine is Lola. And I think a lot of people know Kinks by that song and that song alone. Victoria is another name of a lady now. That was Lola, now Victoria. So let's see what Kinks has to offer through this song.
Victoria is also the name of a place, very popular place in Australia as well as...
must be there in UK as well?
Yeah, maybe in Canada too and many...
Many places.
Yeah.
We had, the name was Victoria Terminus then it was maybe.
Yeah, let's get started. Victoria by the Kinks.
Such as bad, called obscene.
an Englishman's anthem here, Victoria. And in there was another song title of The Doors, Gloria. I'm looking for all those names. We recently we have reacted to The Doors, Gloria, as well as we reacted to Amanda of Boston very recently in this year itself. Victoria, it seems very clear to me. I like the guitar riffs, I like the music, I like the drums, I like the way it was sung. I don't like the anthem that was sung here. Definitely not being from one of the Commonwealth countries who were ruled by Victoria and her leadership. I don't find it very pleasing to begin with.
Yeah.
It was suppression, it was harsh, it was cruel, it was manipulative, it was very brutal rulership of the Brits over these lands. So there was not much love of Victoria we got to feel. And the compassion.
Yeah, the song was fun to listen to.
Yeah.
Good music, but yeah. At the same time, obviously, with our history and knowing it and studying it from school, early school days, elementary till we graduate, you know, you kind of realize that it's being ruled just for the benefit of the ruler, the one who's ruling. So in this case, it was Queen Victoria. Before her, it may have been someone else.
Victoria, I think two Victorias were there. One and then the second, I think.
Yeah, we have watched this movie.
Sure. Yeah, Victoria and Abdul and Victoria.
Interesting
yeah.
Movie. Yeah, interesting. And don't know if it's is it based.
Yeah, it was based on the real story.
True story.
As per the story, actually, Queen Victoria was a very generous and very kind person. Her name used to be used by the rulership, the leadership all over the land, all over, all across wherever they ruled and took their colonies from place to place. But she hardly knew what they were doing with things. She wouldn't get an idea of what they were doing with it. They were mainly misusing her name, keeping her in the dark, and they were doing all sorts of unethical and, you know, barbaric acts on those lands that they ruled, and she was told or given another picture altogether how they were doing things. She didn't even know what a mango looked like, being the Queen of India at that moment.
Queen of India or Queen of England?
I mean, Queen of England and ruling India as well.
Yeah, but the
Indian
thing is,
subcontinent.
Either way, is ruling other countries, is it?
It's a love.
No, is it?
Sake of the love.
That is the wrong way to go about things, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's, of course, now we
freedom
are...
Freedom is more important.
2020, so we can see things for what they are and what they were.
Clearly. Yeah.
Clearly, we already know a lot about the history
In
of the
fact,
world.
The song, the way it is written is so... amusing, I would say, and contradictory. Right in the beginning, he said he likes the freedom of being born on the land of Victoria. That they are free, whether rich or poor, they are free. The same way everybody else also likes to be. Whether rich or poor, we like to be free. We don't like to be ruled by someone. The song began with that.
It's part of our history. It's difficult for us to forget. As Indian reactors, obviously, when a song like that comes, it's difficult for us to just... you know, forget about what the lyrics are all about, what has happened in our history. And it's not something we want to forget.
Yeah.
It's not like the Holocaust that, oh, they want to forget it. They want to pretend it never happened.
Because that's embarrassing.
You know, for the Germans. But for us, definitely not. We don't want to forget what happened. And yeah, forgiveness is something else. I think our ancestors already
but
did
But they didn't
that.
Ask already for forgiveness.
Yeah. No, but we forgive them, our ancestors. In fact, my mother, father were also alive at that time. They were born already when the
they were young,
was
yeah,
born.
About 10 years
so
old.
So definitely, been... I can say that they really didn't. They didn't have any bad things to say about the British, but they definitely in our schools, all our teachers and principals, everyone made it clear that yes, we were ruled by the British, and nobody liked that. You know, as a child also, when we heard that ruled by the British, it was not something...
You feel like a loser.
We're not something that we like to hear. Especially someone like me. Growing up, listening to that again and again in history classes, it was not something I wanted to hear. You don't want to belong to a land which was ruled by someone for so long. So thankfully, we won our freedom and we have good things to talk about it now, how we progressed and developed. So rapidly in the last year, 70-80 years after we've won our independence,
That didn't happen during the 300 years of British rule. That's what is painful for us.
What didn't happen?
The development that we have seen after they left us, after the freedom. They didn't really love us that we actually developed those days. We didn't. It was, everything was at standstill. They were just making people do what they felt like. They wanted people to only produce indigo, 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 indigo. How much indigo do you need food to feed yourself?
But I think at the same time, there were also other cash crops and things that were just taken at dirt cheap prices and forced to be produced.
And after independence, we have had another thing going. So it was a bad rulership.
There was a lot of injustice, you know, and it's all directly connected to the song because whether Queen Victoria, as you say, was in the dark or not, the fact is that she was...
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that was a movie they showed.
She was in charge of things. She had to, you know, decide ultimately what had to be done and not done. So I'm sure she passed it. She sealed, put a seal on all those documents which asked for various things to be done and not done.
Yeah.
Interesting, interesting song. The Kinks.
How did you like the music?
Music was good. I like the music. I like the singing. Very good music, very good singing. It's obviously an Englishman's perspective.
It is an Englishman's
song. So obviously they have every right to talk about their queen and glorify the name of the queen.
Gloria.
And talk about their country and how great it is and all. They have every right to do that. Just like we have a right to do the same for our country. At the end of the day, facts are facts. And... it has been a great injustice done on all the colonies, not just India, but even in Africa, so many countries in Africa, and across the world, you know, other parts of Asia, you know, great injustice done because people in these countries were suppressed and we could have developed a lot more. You know, as Indians, I can talk about India.
We are taken away of all those opportunities. Today we have to work and struggle a lot more we had those 300 years on our side.
With our culture, with our vibrancy, with our diversity, with our phenomenal discipline that we have as a nation, I think we would have been easily way ahead of UK, USA and all other countries.
We are one of the oldest civilizations
on this planet. That's what I'm saying. It was all ruined in those years of being colonized by various people. So it's an interesting song, but yeah.
Not for us.
Not our cup of tea, really. Cup of tea.
See, yeah, let's have some.
That's an English tradition, isn't it?
It's maybe older than their tradition because they took it from India. India had, you know, taken it from China and it passed on. So from East, it went on to the West.
Yeah, we watched a tea documentary or series years ago. Actually, tea has actually, they had roots in China.
China, that's why India calls China Chai. Yeah. That's why the name became Chai, Chin Chai. And because of that, it became China. If you don't know, those are the facts.
Okay. Let's.
Chai is Indian tea.